We did, you know, a lot of work and health promotion, and we tried to make it fun and interesting.
So we started doing the Nonsense Step Show
at Georgia State.
And that's when we start actually taking popular songs and changing them into with health messages. And so that's something all of the EPF kids were involved in. That's, I think that's what kind of started the whole like music parody.
Yeah, so fast forward like 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
We're both young professionals. We both work in nonprofit, and we go to lunch every Monday.
Because it's half off Mondays at Hand in Hand.
Shout out to Hand in Hand. And we were in there talking, and we had just.
No, actually, we were in. This happened when we were in the car, and I was like, "Dad, you know what? We should do like I want to do a music video. I want to do like some kind of video." And you're like, "We should do a parody." And then we're like, well, "What should we do it on?" And then you said, "We should do it on Beyonce pregnancy." And so that's kind of how I did it.
It started. It was like, I made a joke. It was a joke, and then we just stopped talking about it. And then we started eating, and then something popped in my head, and we were like, oh, what if we did this?
And we actually filmed the first part of that.
A lot of the first video that
same day. The same evening.
Yeah.
And then the other part, another day. It literally took
2 days. That was it.
Not even 2 days.
Oh, I had, you know, maybe a total of six hours of shooting.
But it was fun. It was and then. Fun. We realized that we should do a second part, and that's when we added more people to the whole, you know, list. Romaine Phillips.
Yes, and Marcus Borders, and
Nick
Robinson. Kitchen, of course, he was in the first one. And then today we just shot the final.
The trilogy, the final to the trilogy. Yes. Yeah, so shout out to Aaron.
Aaron, Davian.
Jessica. And,
Tim.
So I think we're well at Target. Tim. Thank you.
Target. Shh. There are other questions.
Yes.
But yeah, we have fun. We love it.
You want to hit us up once we get all these hits.
Right. Look up. Oh, yeah, we're going to get like a million.
Hopefully. But that's about it. So, and hopefully we'll have more stuff to come, you know, after this. Hopefully everybody will hit Chase Up Black Jacket Film. For, is it film? I was comfortable the first time and the second time because it was just with people that I knew. But I think today when it was in front of some of the people that I didn't know, I felt a little bit like weird, and I didn't want them to think that I thought that I was like, you know, really that important. Like I was trying to be a diva, but I had to be a diva.
I didn't realize that the actor said cut. But Dominique herself cut several times during production, and she'd just be like, I think one of my eyelashes is out of place, we need to cut.
You know what, yes. This is the thing, I would always tell people, go for what you want, because at the end it's going to turn out better.
That's
turn
true.
Out better. So fight for what you believe in, fight for what you want, because at the end of the day, that cliffhanging scene is going to be bomb.
Okay, I mean, yes.
But you know, I do have to back and realize that I am not a camera woman nor producer, because if Chase was telling me how to do makeup, I would be like, look, this is what I do.
But you know, I appreciate her feedback. I think we work great as a team. High five.
Always. So hopefully
and there is absolutely no tension between us ever.
You know, everyone, we won a Viewer's Choice Award for the OSAP's first Black Annual
Film Festival. first annual Black Film Festival at Georgia State University, sponsored by the Office of
African-American Student Services and Programs.
We won for Countdown, we won Viewer's Choice, and then Romaine won.
He got a couple of different awards, actually.
For his J. Cole video. More stuff.
Commercials.
Music videos.
Whatever makes money.
Wow.